Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri urging the Philippine Coast Guard to cut China's floating barriers in Scarborough Shoal. Zubiri says all illegal structures in the West Philippine Sea should be removed, not just to assert the country's sovereign rights, but also to protect Filipino fishermen in the area. He points out China has no right to put any structures within the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. For Minority Senator Rizal Tiberos, the move shows China's cruelty knows no bounds. She says the Philippines should not let such acts go unpunished and should not allow China's bullying to continue. Simmering maritime tensions between the Philippines and China still. Manila condemning Beijing's installation of floating barriers in a part of the Scarborough Shoal that prevents Filipino fishermen from entering the area. The 300-meter-long barrier was discovered by the Philippine Coast Guard during a routine patrol last Friday. China also issued radio challenges and conducted dangerous maneuvers against Philippine vessels during the patrol.
According to the Filipino fishermen, every time na merong mga nakikita ng China Coast Guard na maraming Filipino fishermen na nangingisda sa immediate surroundings ng Bajo de Masinloc, saka sila naglalatag ng barrier na to. It is a navigational hazard in a way na hindi ka naman talaga, speaking of buoys, no? Buoys are basically used as an aid to navigation to support the mariners, no, na i-identify yung mga dangerous area. Pero itong pagkakataon na to, they are using floating barrier, no, para pagbawalan ang mga Filipino fishermen na makapasok sa loob ng shore.
China claims 90% of the South China Sea, overlapping with the exclusive economic zones of the Philippines, of Vietnam, Malaysia, Brunei, and Indonesia. Manila's 2016 arbitral victory already invalidated China's sweeping claims, but Beijing refuses to recognize that position.
The People's Republic of China is deliberately ignoring the decision of the arbitral award and also deliberately not adhering to the international law. The mere fact that they are still claiming as if Bajo de Masinloc Lagoon belongs to them, kaya sila naglalagay ng floating barrier dito, is illegal and an illegitimate action coming from the People's Republic of China.
The Philippines calls for diplomacy in solving international conflicts during the United Nations General Assembly in New York. Manila's top diplomat, Enrique Manalo, delivered his speech over the weekend where he urged countries to settle disputes through peaceful means. He also reiterated the foreign policy of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. that the Philippines remains a friend to all and an enemy to none.
We advocate the peaceful settlement of disputes in accordance with international law. This has always been our position with respect to the disputes in the West Philippine Sea. Inasmuch as we are prepared to defend our sovereignty, sovereign rights, and territorial integrity. As an archipelagic state whose destiny is intimately linked with the oceans, the Philippines is a champion of the 1982 UN Convention on the Law of the Sea. And we are proud to be among the first states to have signed this week the Treaty on Marine Biodiversity of Areas Beyond National Jurisdiction, which opens new windows to cooperate in the responsible stewardship of the high seas.
The Philippines, Japan, and the U.S. agreed to strengthen security cooperation amid rising tensions in the Indo-Pacific region. Three countries held a trilateral meeting on the sidelines of the UN General Assembly Saturday, where they discussed possible activities to boost cooperation, including the creation of a work plan. They also agreed to call out those who violate international law. The three countries also discussed ways to support economic resiliency and enhance trilateral partnership in several areas, including digital economy. China reveals more details on its reported rescue of two Filipino fishermen off Spratly Islands. The Chinese embassy says it was moved by China's actions, which highlights the importance of humanitarian efforts and cooperation between the nations. It adds the rescue signifies the interconnectedness of Manila and Beijing. Last week, a Chinese local media reported two Filipino fishermen sought help from the People's Liberation Army vessel after one of them suffered wounds. The crew are said to have treated the fisherman's injury and provided food and medical supplies for the two. The Philippine Coast Guard says it has no concrete information regarding that incident. Now, the rescue comes amid China's concerning actions in the West Philippine Sea. On Friday, another Filipino fisherman was chased by speedboats after it sailed near the Scarborough Shoal. Philippine authorities are investigating a faint explosion that damaged three vehicles at the country's main gateway Saturday. Authorities say there were no working CCTV cameras and security guards at the area at Mayia Terminal 3's parking lot, where a glass bottle containing flammable liquid was thrown. No one was reported hurt from the incident. Police say the lack of security measures is concerning.
Meron pong security guard post doon, tatlo. Wala po naka-deploy na security guard at that time. At yung CCTV po ay hindi gumagana. Nagtataka tayo paano napasukan o nangyari yung ganitong insidente sa isang vital installation, airport.
Philippines' top court debunks claims artificial intelligence will be used to check the 2023 bar examinations. This comes after the false news circulated through a Facebook group page for bar exam takers. The Facebook page moderator insists there was no mention that AI will check the bar exams, but will only sort out the correct answers. 2023 bar exam chair Associate Justice Ramon Paul Hernando asserts the exams will be checked by experts. An investigation is underway to hold the person accountable for spreading false information. The Bureau of Customs looking into information that a Chinese mafia is supposedly behind rice smuggling in the country. Customs Director Bernie Enciso said they have received reports regarding the issue. He also assures the public raids in dubious warehouses will continue.
Side ng financing, nasa side po ng distribution or nasa side po sila ng there are other, marami po silang levels kung nasan po sila present eh dito sa agricultural smuggling. So, yan din po isa sa mga tinitingnan ng Bureau of Customs.
Since August, the Bureau of Customs has seized more than 236,000 sacks of smuggled rice from warehouses in Bulacan, 36,000 sacks from Tondo, Manila, and 20,000 sacks from Las Piñas and Cavite. A Philippine agricultural group, meanwhile, urges government to take action on the matter since rice farmers have been greatly affected by smuggling.